why is India supporting PM, Prachanda camp leaders and King simultaneously?
Perhaps we are being too judgmental. India as a neighbor will have had investments and interests in all three. If we are saying also that the Chinese are not supporting, we will be wrong. They will also have had their relations expanded over the years and contacts. Okay. They would want their policies in Nepal to foster. So, what you are seeing here is not just an internationally managed contact, you are also seeing reaction in those contacts. You see. So, the real problem is that politics in Nepal have all three. There is KP, there is Prachanda and Madhav Nepal or Jalanath, and there is the monarchy, although the monarchy is not a constitutional monarchy yet. The world is aware now that very unconstitutional methods were taken to oust the monarchy. And there is also rousing reaction to that now on the streets. Just fostering contacts does not mean supporting. What we see though is there is a need for a change. There is a need to lower the pitch of micromanagement because it has rebounded on India very badly. Over the years, I think that it is only now that you have such vapid anti-Indianism functioning. I mean, just as your question reflects, we dump everything, all our woes on Indian intervention now. That is not serving India. Also, we are surprised at the activities of China, which we never saw before. The message we are getting is that the destabilization of Nepal is affecting both India and China, and there are very, very pertinent corrections necessary and very soon in order not to let the free fall we are in do more damage even in the neighborhood. So we cannot just, you know, 15 years ago, maybe a little more than that, the Indian media were saying the Maoists were run by the Chinese, when in actual fact, they were being run by India. We have very short memories. I have read it, all right? And there are very many corrections due in order to restore the equilibrium in Nepal. That is perhaps why you see that India is reaching out to all three. Even the Nepali Congress. Why have you not included the Nepali Congress or even the RPP? We find that there are very many Indian interests working in these parties also. There's one thing though, the king, as we all have found out now, is the lone institution that guarantees Nepali national interest, and it is not the parties. That is why, because the population is attracted towards the reinstitution of the monarchy, I guess the Indians want a toehold in that movement also. So these are natural diplomatic tendencies. We shouldn't be surprised at it. In fact, at this juncture, we should think that for the Indians to cushion the change, they have a larger role. That is it. India will continue to have these work interests at play, and to their effort, it's common pursuance of national interest. The Chinese will also now. It doesn't look like the traditional Chinese policy of distancing itself from domestic politics. It has not served them well. For the Chinese to distance themselves again from Nepali politics, the Indians will have to make a convincing withdrawal from their traditional policies in Nepal. This is very important. And now, I think in the first place we must, Nepal, India, China, we must have a larger vision about how we are going to cooperate for Asian development, not compete in the Western sense of term, in order to at least maintain a semblance of amity and peace among us. Somehow Nepal has become the focus of competition between the two, which is not conducive to both India and China. We, for us, it has become an expensive exercise, and we see the Indian indulgence in Nepal as rebounding. It is rebounding on India. I guess they have to salvage the whole thing, you know, renew their trade, renew their basic perspectives on South Asian development. We are now seeing, you know, some Indian interest at the revival of Hinduism in Nepal, okay. Something which they actually became a tool to remove from our identification. We are now seeing particularly the Chinese finding it very expensive to condone the federal movement in Nepal, something again the Indians find expensive, but again became a tool to impose on Nepal. And the monarchy we find is a more, both for India and China, I think they have rediscovered that the monarchy is a an institution of stability and leadership, which they do not discover in the leaders they have created for Nepal. Let's see where the trend is. It is not a healthy trend, no doubt, because it should not have been there. The reason the Indians are very concerned is their discovery that the extents of their mishandling has actually encouraged more suspicion and more animosity towards India. That's why they are perhaps patching things up or steering things to a more conducive environment. Let's see.
Okay. Thank you, sir, for joining with us.
You're welcome.